This week in AI news, Google DeepMind has just released its latest GNOME AI breakthrough with 800 years of advances. Pika Labs unveiled its jaw-dropping AI capable of generating and editing Pixar-quality level videos, and Meta revealed three new AI models with demos. But first, we'll delve into the origins of Pika Labs and explore their launch of seven new features set to transform video creation as we know it. Founded in April 2023 by two Stanford Computer Science PhD students, Pika Labs was born from the two founders' shared vision and inspiration from Runway, a generative AI video startup. The founders decided to create a more intuitive and user-friendly platform for text-to-video, image-to-video, and video-to-video creation, which led to the birth of Pika Labs. And Pika Labs has quickly gained popularity, where within a year of being launched on Discord, it has already attracted over 500,000 users and $55 million in funding. Now, enabling text, image, and video-to-video conversions, plus much more, Pika 1.0 focuses on enhancing the user experience with a sleek, minimalist style inspired by Runway, but with additional tools that maintain simplicity. It also integrates features from Midjourney, such as an explore mode, providing users access to various artworks for inspiration. Furthermore, the core functionality from the Discord version is retained, but presented in a refreshed format, with an upcoming release of a mobile app on the roadmap. But one of the real standout features in Pika 1.0 is video-to-video transformation, allowing users to alter existing videos into different styles using text prompts. This feature, though previously seen in early versions of other platforms, exhibits a polished execution in Pika 1.0. Another innovative aspect is AI-assisted manipulation of video aspect ratios, catering to various social media formats like TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube Shorts. The platform also introduces generative fill editing tools, enabling users to replace elements in a scene through simple prompts. While still in its early stages, this feature promises exciting possibilities. And for those in the entertainment industry, the high-quality CGI animation capabilities of Pika 1.0 are particularly exciting. These advancements are nearing the quality of renowned studios like Pixar and DreamWorks, with lifelike lighting and convincing facial expressions. Finally, a significant update in Pika 1.0 is the extension of clip lengths beyond 3 seconds, similar to the functionality in Runway. This allows users more flexibility and creative freedom in their video projects. However, Pika is not alone in its journey within the AI video landscape. Adobe Systems' acquisition of rephrase.ai and Meta's introduction of Emu Video highlight the escalating interest in AI-driven video technologies. Similarly, the release of Stable Video Diffusion by Stability AI and updates to Runway ML by Runway demonstrate the intensifying competition in the AI video generation market. But onto the meat and potatoes, as Google DeepMind has just unveiled its new AI tool named GNOME to revolutionize material science by quickly achieving what would have previously taken 800 years using traditional crystal research methods. Furthermore, as recently detailed in a Nature publication, this AI tool has identified over 2.2 million new crystals, including around 380,000 stable compounds with potential applications in future technologies. These technologies range from advanced superconductors to improved batteries and innovative semiconductors. This transforms the arduous task of discovering new crystal structures, as traditionally finding new inorganic crystals was a slow and painful process. But GNOME changes the game by employing graphene networks to not only identify potential new materials, but also to predict their stability. This method promises to uncover more materials in a shorter time than has been possible in centuries. GNOME's efficiency is a result of active learning, a process that combines AI with quantum physics. Initially trained with publicly available data on known materials from the Materials Project, GNOME's performance saw a significant boost. By suggesting new materials and testing their stability through quantum physical density functional theory, the AI's prediction accuracy for material stability jumped from about 50% to over 80%. DeepMind also managed to enhance the model's efficiency, elevating the discovery rate from below 10% to over 80%. This improvement could reduce the computational resources needed for each discovery. Some of GNOME's predictions have already been proven in practice, with other labs synthesizing 736 of the forecasted new crystals. The data on the 380,000 most stable candidates have been made publicly accessible, offering a rich resource for researchers worldwide to develop new technologies. In a related development, researchers at Berkeley Labs Experimental Robotics Laboratory, ALAB, have synthesized 41 new materials in just 17 days using an automated process. This system autonomously chose the ingredients, conducted the synthesis, and analyzed the results. However, even with the advancements in automated laboratories, the sheer number of theoretical structures identified by systems like GNOME exceeds current synthesis capabilities. This highlights an emerging need for AI that can not only predict new materials, but also determine which ones are worth synthesizing, bridging the gap between theoretical discovery and practical application. Meanwhile, Meta has just introduced three of its cutting-edge AI research projects, Ego Exo 4D, Seamless Communication, and Audiobox, with these projects showcasing Meta's ability to continue pushing AI technology forward across diverse fields like video learning, translation, and audio generation. The first project, Ego Exo 4D, represents a significant leap in video learning and multimodal perception. This dataset and benchmark, developed collaboratively by Meta's fundamental AI research project ARIA and 15 global university partners, span over 2 years of data collection. It uniquely combines egocentric views from a camera-equipped headset and exocentric views from surrounding cameras. The focus is on capturing complex human activities like sports, music, and cooking, presenting a wealth of data for AI research. Meta envisions this dataset enhancing AR systems, robotic learning, and social networks by facilitating skill acquisition and knowledge sharing through videos. This extensive dataset, with over 1,400 hours of video, will be open-sourced in December, followed by a benchmark competition next year. The second project is Seamless Communication, which is a suite of AI research models designed to revolutionize language translation. Building on the earlier Seamless M4T model, this project introduces four new models: Seamless Expressive, Seamless Streaming, Seamless M4T V2, and a combined Seamless model. These models aim to preserve speech nuances, reduce translation latency, and enable smoother voice and text communication across languages. A demo of Seamless Expressive, showcasing voice translation, highlights Meta's strides in making communication more natural and barrier-free. The third project, Audiobox, marks Meta's foray into generative AI for audio. Succeeding its predecessor, Voicebox, Audiobox offers enhanced control by allowing users to generate specific voices and sound effects through voice input and text prompts. This model is set to empower creators with tools to produce custom audio content easily.